All right, let's get this show on the road. It is first and ten.
Here we go, Simon.
We'll give up the gut to Walker. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down. Working quickly here. From the 38. Into the hands of Walker.
That's a defense's goal, right, Kate? Just get us to third down so we can have a chance to get off the field. And that was a good adjustment on that stop in particular, when the back ended up being the target and they were able to keep him short of the sticks.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and two.
There we go, Sinola.
Throwing now, off play action. Toward the sideline, and he's got it. Impressive play, but they are well shy of the first down. Getting three on that game. And it sets up Seattle with first down.
That's what we call situational football. You spend all week working on your nickel passing game package to take advantage of third downs just like that.
He's got it. Room to run. They manage 22 on the rip and a first down.
Yeah, I love that effort. Adding as much as possible to that catch while earning the first down. That's called yards after catch. And it's what coaches want from all their pass catchers on the roster.
And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. Halfway there on first down. That brings up second and five.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
Ready!
From the 31. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's down inside the red zone before hitting the deck. That's an 11-yard pickup, and it gives them the first down.
That's just great instincts. Go air it out on second down rather than just play conservative and run it. They hit a weak point in the coverage and don't need to worry about third down at all.
Hey, everybody.
Working inside the red zone. Cut near the goal line. And they'll get this down nearly to the end zone. Instead, stuffed at the two. They'll have first and goal to go now after they gained 18 on the previous play.
You know what I like about that, Kate? I like that they're not coming out slow. They're willing to go with some looks here that will yield big yardage down the field instead of just settling for dinking and ducking the ball.
They'll try and punch it in. And they take it across the goal line. Touchdown, Seattle! The Seahawks finish up an excellent opening series. Now it's Jason Myers on for the extra point. Splits the uprights, and they add one on to their first touchdown of the contest.
Jason Myers to kick off.
Here's Myers now to handle the kickoff. Kickoff taken at the three. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Allen, the motion man, left. Here's Williams. Finds his target, Allen. They gain 14 on the play. And that's good for a Bears first down.
I love throwing a first down. And when you see a first down pass just like that, it's taking advantage of a matchup you plan for, and you go out and execute.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42.
Let's go. Go.
Williams to throw. And that's incomplete. A little lucky there, too. Nearly picked up on first down.
I think I could see his eyes from the booth. He was envisioning the return and simply drop it. You gotta secure the pick before anything else.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call.
Here we go, here we go. 19, pioneer.
Now here's Williams. An all-around tough play for him. He took a shot on the release, and it definitely affected the throw. It's incomplete.
You need to buy your receivers enough time to get open along their route, and your quarterback enough time to find and hit them with the throw. When the line doesn't hold up, incompletions follow.
So after that prior incompletion, we've got third down. Back now, pressure on its way. That's going to fall incomplete. Either way, he was breaking it up. Couldn't be around with a pick, so hits the ground, brings up fourth down.
You feeling lucky? Well, do you? Well, he should, because quarterback got away with one right there. That was an easy pick dropped by the defense.
Still staying out after the incompletion. They're going to try on four.
Let's go now.
Oh, they're going for this. They can't connect as the coverage comes through. The fourth down stand.
Quarterback so worried about challenging the DBs in coverage, he can keep an eye on the lineman in front of him. He threw it right towards him, and it was easy to get a pop up and swat away a potential first down.
And they'll get it down for a solid gain to about the 37. First down play, nets him five. It's going to be second and five.
It's got to be so demoralizing as a defense when you go up against a running back who just keeps those legs churning like a piston in an engine. And that effort's contagious. This entire offense is getting a boost, and he busts those tackles. I'm just going to say, maybe not the guy you want to pick on in coverage of this particular series. Gets a hand on that throw and knocks it away the next time, or he could get two hands on it and take it the other way.
No connection on the last play, and now it's third down. Throwing is Smith. That's caught for the first. And he'll go down here at the 16. It's a 21-yard gain. And the Seahawks will have a first down.
And the Seahawks.
Here we go.
From the red zone now. Won't make the play on that one. It hits the deck, incomplete. Trying to find his tight end. So second down coming up.
Well, he needed another second to deliver the throw he wanted to. You got to give a lot of credit that time, Kate, to the pass rush for getting in and forcing him to dish it.
And he's got it across the goal line for a touchdown. So, Brock, this offense looking sharp here in the first half as they extend their lead.
You know, and when things are going well, sometimes you really just get into a groove. And this is a unit that's putting the pieces together.
That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead.
Jason Myers to kick off.
Here's Myers now to handle the kickoff. Kickoff taken at the three. And he gets across the 30 before he's brought down.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
It's a new set of downs for him at the 32. Williams will look to throw. And oh, someone stepped in. It's intercepted. Rayshon Dickens makes the play. And the Seahawks get the football back with great field position there at the 36. Wanted to hit his tight end there, but a defender anticipated it, got a hand on it, and it is picked off.
Yeah, I think this defense is today have figured it out. There's a lot of good tight ends, and they can be mismatch makers, so you better have an awareness and coverage of where those tight ends are. This defense did, and boy, what a big play to take that ball away.
Play action on first down. Throwing deep for the end zone.
That is such a bummer. A dropped touchdown right in the end zone. We're gonna see how quickly he can flush this one. He better, because they gotta make an impact later.
Caught him deep behind the line. Oh, the ball is out! Bears pick it up, headed the other way. And he'll bring the fumble back for a touchdown. Step one is just making the hit, Brock. Step two, trying to knock the football out with that hit, and they were even fortunate enough to get to step three, weren't they? Taking that fumble all the way back for a touchdown.
And just look at them. I love the joy. The unit that doesn't get to celebrate in the end zone all too often, they will welcome the chance to be the guys running it in for a change. Cue up the group celebration, and boys, go enjoy the moment.
That one splits the uprights, and they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. Still reeling a little after fumbling that away, but they're going to get it right back with this kickoff. Return coming from the six. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. They're out and set, first and 10.
49, flip it off, 49. There we go, Sonoma.
Now an inside give to Walker. And that's only 1 yard up the middle. Hey, gonna be second down. Offense in the hurry up here.
Here we go, Sunday.
Here we go, second and 9. And that catch is made down the right sideline. Great effort there.
I'm sure coach, play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
About set for the second quarter. Seahawks football here. They've got first and 10 here, looking to add to their lead. He rolls to his right. Now he takes it. He's out in the clear. They get 28 out of that play. And it sets up Seattle with first down.
Man, I don't ever want to be a defensive coordinator. They do so many things right to take away the pass. And then what happens? Well, you get a quarterback that lowers his head, gashes the defense with one of the biggest runs of the game. You take away the pass, but you can't stop the QB run.
They'll keep this drive moving and come to the line for first and 10.
There we go.
Smith. It's Cup Metcalf. And he's brought down inside the 10 at the 9. A nice pickup of 11 there, Brock, and they'll have first and goal to figure out.
That is what elite offenses are all about. Why worry about three downs when you need only one? Move the chains in one play and keep driving that defense backwards.
Ready!
Here's a give on first and goal. And they beat him to the edge. That run stopped back at the line.
Hey, on tackle.
Moving quickly, trying to get set again.
No gain on the play.
They're going play action. Headed out right. And oh, he got it! Interception! That is Kyler Gordon.
Not a lot of one play swings bigger than that one right there. That throw looked destined for six, and instead, well, it gets intercepted by the defense. The only way to get bigger is if he somehow returned it 100 plus yards for six the other way. But what a gigantic swing of emotion.
Here we go, Scott.
Looking to throw here and shake off that previous INT. He's got him that swift. And what a hit there. Ouch, she faced the price for moving the chains that time.
To this day, I can still see the faces of the big guys in the huddle. When you call a screen like that, instead of them just getting knocked backwards, they get to be salesmen. They get to push those linemen downfield and then tee off and go hit somebody like they did right there.
To throw, Williams. And they get there to take him down right around the 41. They'll take that kind of passing from the rookie out of USC. He gets him the first.
This entire play, Kate, depends on how well he can separate from his man. You get man-to-man coverage, it's really about two things: separation and trust. Because QBs want to throw it before he breaks, that's the trust, and then they got to believe that that separation can create the big play down the field.
Oh, he put everything he had into that throw. He's got it inside the 10. And he'll score. Touchdown, Chicago. The Bears earn the chance to tie before halftime. Santos now for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And we're all knotted up. The Bears kicking team all ready to go, and they kick this one away. His return starts at the 5. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. And the drive will start out with a 1st and 10.
Here we go.
Trying to shake off the interception. He's looking to throw. Metcalf there to bring it in. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. It's a great pickup. 16 yards, and now they've got 1st down. Big shot to begin the drive, has him up beyond the 40. Smith to the air now. Connects with Fant. And he's able to get this to the 32 before going down. It's a pickup of 26. And the Seahawks will have a 1st down.
You know, Kate, you'll find teams go to this crossing route concept sometimes a dozen times a game. A lot of times it's for shorter yardage, but sometimes things break in the right coverage for a much bigger impact play, just like that.
Pass complete to Walker. And he's going to be brought down at the 23-yard line. Seahawks in their hurry-up offense. They need to get everyone to the line. From the 23. And he just got it away before the hit, but the pass winds up incomplete. It's going to be 3rd down.
That is a DB's best friend, pressure. That pressure earned that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target and hit him to alter that last-second attempt to get rid of it.
Third down from the gun. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact.
See the pass, time up your hit, and jar that ball loose. Not a lot of players are hanging on through a well-placed hit like that one.
Third down pass didn't work, but the offense staying out there on 4th. And the QB keeps it on the sneak. And he moves the chains. Now we're going to get an offensive timeout. So that's their 1st. They'll have 2 left to work with before halftime. Only 1 yard, but when all you need is an inch or two, Brock, that'll still move the chains. A new set of downs awaits them. Here's 1st and 10.
Here we go, here we go.
Smith setting the throw. And they get this down to the 7-yard line. Now Seattle gonna call it 2nd timeout. And they still have 1 in their pocket for what's left of this half.
I don't care how good a secondary you are, how loaded you are with talent, when you've got time to allow a receiver to work from one side of the field all the way to the other versus zone.
And he's across for the touchdown. They know that's an offsides call. Myers to add the PAT. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. stop. Return coming from the 6. And he'll break the 15, but not get much further. Tough field position to start this one out. Just over 30 seconds left in the half as they come to the line. Now Williams. To left sideline, complete. That goes as a gain of 25 yards and picks up the first.
Speaks to this guy's talent as just an all-around difference maker, playmaker. We see him line up as a receiver, and we don't even bat an eye, Kate. And we don't really bat an eye when he makes that kind of play either. This guy's just different, built for the moment.
Big shot to begin the drive, has him up beyond the 40. To throw is Williams. Completed here to Komet. And he's able to get this to the 32 before going down. Now we're going to get an offensive timeout. That's their first. They'll have 2 left to work with before halftime.
From a great throw to a nice route and catch to moving the chains, there wasn't a whole lot not to like about that amazing play.
Here's Williams. Throwing all the way to the end zone here. And no one had a shot at that. It's at the back of the end zone, incomplete. That throw doesn't lead to 6. And we'll see what they do here on second down. They'll throw it again. Looking for the end zone and a deep shot. It's another first half mistake. He's intercepted again. Picked off by Devin Witherspoon. And the Seahawks make the defensive stand and come through with a turnover in the final moments of the half.
Well, that's now his second time that he's put his defense in a tough spot. That's a hard thing about playing quarterback, Kate. You know, with these interceptions and now the second on the day, you're asking your defense again to step up to another series, another possession, another challenge. This quarterback's got to start protecting the football.
Now the offense going to take its third and final timeout. And that's all they've got for what little remains of this half. All right, this is going to be the play that takes us to halftime.
Here we go, 13 next. Check 58. Double set.
Looking to throw. Oh, put some heat on this deep ball. Left side. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. So we finished 2 quarters. A couple more to come after this short break. More of the NFL on EA Sports after this. Back from the break, I'm Kate Scott, joined by Brock Heward, and we are just moments away from the beginning of our second half. Here's Myers now to handle the kickoff. Return coming from the 6. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. They'll get this drive started. 1st and 10. Hand off running right. Here's Swift. And he's going to get this up to the 45 before he's brought down. That's 16 on the pickup. And that's a Chicago first down.
You know, Kate, if you notice those guys that love to feed themselves on the field, right, they love to just get more and more. They're hungry for even more. tell you what, that tackle, it prevented something that's going to be a lot bigger. But that back remains hungry.
Give him a few yards on that run. It's second and seven.
You know, they got some positive yards. That's a good thing. But too many plays like that, it just is too hard to pile together, get first downs against the better defenses in this league.
Second down now, seven to go. Staying grounded with Swift. Jukes one defender. They're across the 40. Nice run here. And he gets this down to the 38. He gets a pickup of 14 yards as the chains reset.
Ooh, I like that. I really like that execution to move the chains. Now that third down call that they had ready, well, they could stick it right back in the pocket for a later occasion.
Allen on the catch. And he'll get this down at the 33-yard line.
That's a pretty similar result to a first down run play. Moves it forward, keeps you on schedule, and makes second and third down a whole lot easier to manage.
Halfway to the marker, it's second and five.
Let's go now.
Now here's Williams. Open receiver, caught. And he has it down to the 8-yard line on the play. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
That's just discipline with a capital D. The play in the huddle is a running back screen, but it takes discipline for that offensive line to not get downfield. Discipline for that receiver to stay alert, stay aware that he's a viable option as well.
Swift hauls it in. And he'll score. Touchdown, Chicago! The Bears cut into the lead coming out of halftime. DeAndre Swift, the touchdown. That one right down the middle. And we're all tied up. The Bears kicking team all ready to go, and they kick this one away. His return starts at the five. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. Offense ready to begin this drive. First and ten.
There we go, Snowden.
Now he'll throw off the play fake. He's got it. Room to run. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
And those are the completions they rely on from their passing game.
Markers reset, ball at the 37.
Ready.
They'll run here on first down. And he's brought down by a collective effort there, only 1 yard on the carry. A dose of the hurry up offense here.
1 yard.
Smith back to throw. Got a man open, complete. And they get there to take him down right around the 41. It's a gain of 21 yards to pick up that first down.
They've run this 12-yard hot route cave to combine, well, all the way back to last century when I had to throw. In this throw, this is a big boy throw. It's a differentiator. Can you make that deep out throw on time, on rhythm, and accurately? Well, that was teaching tape right there.
First and 10 from the 41.
There we go.
Fakes the handoff, now to throw. Well, the pressure nearly got to him, but still a good play defensively as that one falls incomplete.
And this is why scouts talk about a player's closing speed, Kate. You know, once he senses the pressure, he's getting rid of that ball. It takes a player who can close quickly to get to him before it's released. And that sure altered the...
This has been a trend, yet another interception. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker. Space, left sideline, and he's off to the races. And he's gonna go. It's a pick six. That play, Brock, that play was beautiful. Not just making the interception, but then seeing the return slowly come together in front of him as he took it all the way to the house.
Yeah, I think think even for us up here in the booth, it looked like a scene out of a movie, didn't it? Starts running it back, scans the field for a lane, then the blocks come just in the nick of time to wipe out the would-be tacklers, and he's got open space and nothing but the end zone in front of him.
Return coming from the six. And in the end, he's able to get it to what used to be a touchback. It's at the 25 after the return. Drive starts out with a first and 10.
Alert. Here we go.
Back to the air following the pick six. That's incomplete, trying to set up the screen there.
Well, that's one you chalk up to the pressure earning that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target, hit him, altered that last second attempt to get rid of it.
Second and 10 now. Walker hauls it in. What a hit! He gets flattened to the ground. We'll see what they come up with for third down in just a bit. We've reached the end of three. It's the Seahawks with possession, needing to erase that deficit in a hurry. Let's see what they draw up on this third and 7.
Hey, here we go, hey.
Back to throw it. And he won't escape. The Bears take him down. And the defense comes through to back him up ahead of fourth down.
It's fourth down.
Hey, on the ball.
Offense up to the line fast. Desperation time on fourth down. He can't get away. They get the sack and force a turnover on downs. And they don't get a desperately needed first down. They're going to still trail after they turn it over on downs. Running behind center with Swift. And they bring him down pretty quickly at the 10. It's a gain of 3 for him. That brings up 2nd and 7.
You know, not a ton of yards, but still showing that commitment to the ground game. The type of run that keeps the defense from loading up in coverage and focusing entirely on that passing game.
Before he can get to the line. The Seahawks calling for a timeout. So they're 1st of 3. They still have 2 to work with in this final quarter.
I got to be honest with you, Kate. That's an occasion where a drop would have been a whole lot better than a completion. Couldn't find the way back to the line, and it's a rare pass that actually loses yardage.
The Hawks dialing up the nickel D here, 3rd down. He'll throw it. Fires over the middle. Caught. And he gets absolutely popped to end that one.
You know, I like the completion. You never turn down a completion. That's just not the right throw to make in that spot to move the chains.
And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that'll push it to double digits in a 2-possession game.
The best kickers I've been around here over the last few decades, they relish these moments. They know the hard work all their buddies on offense and defense have done. And when they can make it a 2-score game and be clutch when it matters, these are the moments they live for.
Find some space. He's past the 30.
And it's a nice return here. They'll tackle him shy of the 35. This will be the last play before our two-minute warning.
Hey, trio left.
Smith. He's going to push one deep down the right. And he's going to be brought down at the 35-yard line. Need to work as quick as you can here, Brock. Two timeouts left, down two scores. It's first down. Now to throw. Metcalf's got it, complete. And he's down inside the red zone before hitting the deck. Seahawks in their hurry-up offense. They need to get everyone to the line. It's incomplete. Should have been a catch downfield, but off his hands and to the ground it goes. No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down.
Here we go, here we go.
Looking to throw it. And what a risk, but he can't hang on. No interception, but nearly a turnover in the end zone.
Well, that's not the uniform you want to see almost bringing it in. They are so fortunate to have another shot down here after the near pick.
Here he is to throw. And that was probably their last gasp. It's intercepted. Tremaine Edmonds has it. Oh, man, Brock. They decided to air it out in pursuit of a touchdown that time. But it's intercepted, and the visit to the red zone comes up empty.
And that one stings, Kate. It really does. You have a limited opportunity of looks in that close, particularly as we get through the second half. The ones you get, you have to. You have to finish with points.
On first down, they'll run. And he'll get this up to the 18-yard line. Now Seattle gonna call its second timeout. And they are quite frustrated having to call that after giving up the first.
Easily had the yardage for a first, but he was hungry for a lot more. I think that tackle prevented something that was gonna be a lot bigger than just a first down pickup.
His pass caught by Allen. And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot. The defense takes its third and final timeout. That's all they had, so the offense free to start running the clock down now. A give right side for Swift. And he's taken down after a short rush in about the 36. 3 yards on the first down play, and that brings up second and seven. Going run again with Swift. And the defense waiting for him at the line, and he goes down. No gain on the play, and it brings up third and seven. Short side option here. He's running left. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. First and 10 from the 41. Herbert straight ahead. And he's able to drive this to the 29 before the stop. So the Bears take this one on the road. And it was a game for fans of high-scoring football, wasn't it? I know Brock was enjoying seeing both of these offenses work, and really not a lot to dislike from either group. Just one side working at a slightly better clip than the other. That's the difference in the win. That does it for another broadcast of the NFL on EA Sports. With my partner in the booth, Brock Huard, I'm Kate Scott. The Bears winners, as we say so long from Seattle.